Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. I am Shota, he is Jason, and we are here to present Seoul Broadcasting System. Our other group member, David, was unable to join us because of a personal reason. He's very sorry for his absence. Alongside the well-known genre of K-pop stands another phenomenal medium, K-drama. Not only has K-drama played an important role in the entertainment industry, it has played a more important role in defining the notion of Korean culture for those who were not previously acquainted with the idea of Korean culture. K-drama, as popular as it is in South Korea, has played a more important role in defining what Korean culture is to countries like Asia, countries in Asia such as China, Japan, Thailand, and Vietnam. Going over basic information. SBS broadcasting was launched in December 9, 1991, 9 months after SBS radio was first created. It has a total revenue of 262 trillion Korean won, which is about $229 billion. It has a market share of 10.5% in the broadcasting industry, which places it fourth place after NBC, KBS, and CJ. In 2005, for the past few years, SBS was falling behind NBC and KBS in both market share and revenue. And at this date, the two larger companies would take over all the market share that SBS used to have. So in this fierce competition, SBS had to do something so that they would not lose all of the market share. So SBS came up with a brilliant idea of partnering with MTV Network Asia, because MTV is an entertainment brand targeted at the younger population. Such partnership has shifted the audience to a more younger population and diversified the audience in the Korean country. The more diverse audience, not only adults, but they include a younger population who consume sports, news, radio, and gaming. As a result, SBS was able to grow 31% of the profit in just 1 year, just by having a consumer priority and catering to their needs. The change also allowed SBS to compete at the same level with KBS and NBC without having to give up most of its market share. Strategically, SBS knew how to stay ahead of the curve and realized that Korean TV platform can cater to a more diverse viewing audience as well. When the younger generation takes up about half of the entire population, it was important to take a step back and to find out who the real audience was. This partnership, you can say, was one of the first partnerships in Korea that symbolized Korean acceptance of Western influence and industry practices, and opened the gates for other TV platforms to follow the strategy to start diversifying their audiences as well. Today, you can see in many major TV broadcasting systems that one channel is dedicated for different purposes, such as movie, gaming, news, or even radio. This ensures that the broadcast can cover a wide range of audiences, ensuring that consumption is maximized. Such an innovation was inspired by SBS in 2005.
Now, these are some of the shows that have allowed us to extend our target markets to other countries. So in the middle, you can see Running Man. This was a program that was started in 2010, and this was the time when SBS had made its official largest contract with China to sell over episodes. On top of this, China additionally created a replica version of Running Man that is still running well in China. And here to the left, we can see Lover from Another Star, as another group has mentioned for us. And on top of that, we have Legend of the Blue Sea that was started in 2016. And this yielded the largest profits for SBS, as each episode was $500,000. And there were 20 episodes, resulting in $10 million revenue from just selling episodes to one Chinese contractor. And despite the successes of 2010, 14, and 16, we are bound to see a hard year in 2017. This is because of the thawed agreement, or the thawed crisis. This is when South Korea was to allow hosting of a U.S. defense missile system in Korea that would use a radar to detect any missiles inbound. And because the forward-based radar encompasses China, a large portion of China as well, China was in opposition against this. And in order to act against it, China set an unofficial embargo in South Korea, restricting physical goods, exports, imports, and even cultural goods such as dramas, news, or movies. And this was a large problem for us, and this is why we will give you a recommendation. We thought that it would be better if SBS could shift their focus over to other parts of the world, such as South or Central America, because they are thriving right now with Netflix and Nape as the mediums of entertainment. However, there is not to worry because China, as abrupt as their sanctions were, they are already beginning to loosening up their sanctions as we are allowed to perform and have musicals in China once again.
If the case study of Seoul rocket system was to teach us something, it would be the identification of lead gaps and megatrends. One of the ways in which SBS was able to differentiate itself from competitors was to recognize that there were growing consumption of Korean media in countries such as Japan and China, and to enter the entertainment markets to compete with their domestic counterparts. Following up those realization is simple and straightforward, such as partnering up with another media company abroad. To be the first to recognize and notice potential trends and need gaps is what dictates success in the market for the following few years. Secondly, business should always be sensitive to trends, not just in the market in this region, but also within global markets as well. This wider perspective will provide a more comprehensive view of the industry, giving a better sense of strategies that can be adopted for growth in the near future. Companies like SBS were able to find ahead of the curve amongst other rocket companies in Korea, since it realized the global trends and applied it to business strategy before any company was able to. Thank you.
Questions from the audience?
By any chance? Can I? Alright. One question reminds me of it's a subsidiary company and its branding strategy. You know, SBS, CNBC? The existence of this kind of cable company? You know, SBS, CNBC? Have you heard about this?
Could you repeat that?
SBS, CNBC. No, no. Okay. I was just wondering, how would their branding strategy affect, what should the SBS do for international cooperation? Essentially, SBS, CNBC is a joint venture between CNBC. You watch that in New York City, right? So they formed a joint venture together with it, labeled it as SBS CNBC. Is this a sound strategy to do it, or what should they do? That was my question, but it seems like you're okay. All right, let's give them a round of applause, and we'll take about 20 minutes break, and then we'll come back for the next session, all right? Thank you.